Ewan McGregor has The Shining, and this is Collider News. There's Perry. I'm Riley. We're breaking it down. All right, Perry Nemiroff, the day has come. We are big fans of Stephen King's Dr. Sleep, which is the sequel to The Shining. And now we have the casting, which is Ewan McGregor is going to play a grown-up Danny Torrance in The Shining sequel. This thanks to Justin Kroll over at Variety. Immediately, your thoughts.
Immediately, my thoughts were, thankfully, I'm able to speak today.
I know,
because
right?
I would have been so upset if anybody else covered this news but the two of us. You guys all know how much I adore this book. Mm. And I love The Shining, the book and the movie in different ways. And I love how this picks up with Danny when he's so much older. And really how it opens the door into a much wider world than I ever realized existed in The Shining. And for some reason, I don't know, when they started putting this whole thing together, I didn't think we would get as familiar of a face in the role as Ewan McGregor. I think it was because I was kind of nervous for the idea of having such a famous person in there that I wouldn't be able to dissociate from,
I know what you're saying,
from
yeah,
the star power and really lose myself and believe that's Danny Torrance. Because even though Danny Torrance in The Shining is super, super young, it's still a character that I'm familiar with. So I always thought that they were going to go with, you know, maybe a little more of an uppercomer, but locking Ewan McGregor is a pretty great get. And the second I saw that headline paired with that image of him, like, I would buy this.
I buy it. I screamed. I showed Perry the article, and here we are doing the news. So as you know, Mike Flanagan, who did direct a King novella, Gerald's Game, he is directing, and this comes on the heel of It doing bang up boffo box office. And they put a number of Stephen King properties in development, but over the years, they were working on this, and they were working on an Overlook Hotel prequel. So everything that happened before The Shining. Perry, do you think with any kind of success off of this adaptation, we will see the Overlook prequel?
Oh, yeah. I mean, with success in anything, you're going to see more of it. And I think they set up this project really well. The fact that we're hearing about Danny Torrance casting right now, I think, is a good sign for them really giving this project enough prep time, because the movie doesn't come out until January 2020. And, you know, that used to be considered a dumping ground. And now we've got movies that are typically hitting in the last few, in the last 2 weeks, maybe more the last week of January, and some of them are making a ton of money, so that could be a really good position to have carved out. But back to Ewan McGregor really quickly, the thing that I think he's going to be good at with this role, or I think one thing he's going to be able to capture, is, you know how Danny is. I mean, we're not getting into any spoilers here, but when he grows up, you know, he's a good guy with a dark side to him. He's got some demons, and you need someone who's going to be able to capture both sides of him and still make him feel like a whole person. And I do have faith that Ewan McGregor can pull that off.
That's right. And no spoilers here for Dr. Sleep, but as you can imagine, if you think about kicking off from The Shining or at the end of The Shining, Danny Torrance grows up having lost his father, seen a bunch of ghosts, and dealing with his Shining all in the aftermath. So we do have Ewan McGregor. You will see him in Christopher Robin coming out this August. It's a very different part for him. We're going to keep our eye on this, as well as more casting for Dr. Sleep. But what do you guys think? Are you excited for Ewan McGregor to be playing an older Danny Torrance? He does have The Shining, so we're going to get some psychic abilities, not those force abilities, those psychic abilities in The Shining sequel, Dr. Sleep. I'm very excited. Drop some comments. Tell us what you think about the casting and who else you'd like to see if you know the material surround the casting of Ewan McGregor. Remember to like and share this video. We want everybody aware of Dr. Sleep. It's coming January of 2020. That's Perry Nemiroff. I'm Mark Riley. We will see you soon.